Hello, and welcome back to whatever this is. So in this video, I just kind of wanted to take a couple steps back from my usual content and just essentially discuss why I'm here on YouTube and essentially run you through a little bit of what I plan for the future of this channel and essentially just kind of introduce you to my thought process of why I'm here. I really want to talk about digitization and colonialism and capitalism and all of the other wonderful things that we have currently going on in 2021 that is also affecting the museum and cultural heritage sector. No one is really talking about this on YouTube. There are a handful of conservatives that are on YouTube as well as actual museums, like institutional YouTube pages where you can learn about various objects and ASMR, I guess, is a thing now. And don't get me wrong, like these channels are awesome and they're really, really important, I think, especially as museums are kind of struggling to keep up with a world in lockdown. So we have all of these channels that are talking about the history and the things, the artifacts, the archives, and all of the things that a museum collection contains. But nobody's really talking about the museums themselves. Like, if you ask somebody out on the street what a museum is, they're gonna say, oh, that's where they keep all of the old stuff. But most people wouldn't really be able to answer beyond that. So that's kind of why I'm here. I kind of want to bridge that gap between the public and the museum as an institution. And a lot of people are still talking about museums with a capital M, and not just the things that they contain, like on blog posts and on Twitter. But it's all mainly text-based and how this information is being conveyed. Or you might see an infographic or something that talks about, museums increased digitization by 15% over the pandemic, yay! But like, I feel there's so much more to unpack there. And I think that talking like this, it's a more effective way of conveying information and also just getting a point across, in my personal opinion. And this is also just more fun. Honestly, it's more fun than reading blog posts about digitization. There are an absolute ton of like Twitters and Instagrams and Facebook groups, blog posts that discuss these sort of things, but I feel like a lot of the people that are reading them are other museum professionals. And I think my main intent with this channel is to try and reach the general public, because I think that that is kind of where the future of, well, that's where the future of museums lie, right? We can't open our doors and we can't sustain ourselves without the help of the public. And so I think that really what we need to be doing is, for one thing, just in general, we need to be a lot better about gatekeeping. We need to make sure that our collections are accessible. We need to digitize. We need to engage the public in new ways and just try and keep up with social media and all of these different ways that we now have the ability to engage people with. So with these videos, my target audience is the general public. Like, museum professionals, if you're here, I'm glad to have you. I encourage feedback if you have any. I will eagerly devour it. I want to try and bridge the gap between museums and the public, because I feel like there's a bit of a disconnect. And I want to talk about not just accessibility for the general public, but how when I was a broke university student who was studying museums, I couldn't actually enter a museum because I couldn't afford the entry fee. And that's the reality for a lot of people. The entire purpose of a museum is knowledge and learning, but we have these invisible barriers that are put up that prevents numerous populations within our greater population from actually taking part in that knowledge. And yes, while the main intent of this channel is to discuss museums and their various relevant topics, I also do want to talk about history, mainly just because, well, I want the excuse to learn more about a different topic, whatever I decide, because I probably wouldn't actually do the research if I didn't have an excuse, because that's just how my brain works. I kind of need to have a purpose to actually look into something. It's like, oh, sea shanties. Those are neat and sweeping the internet. That's cool. But what if I made a video about it and I did some research on it and then I shared that information of whatever I find? and compile it into a fun little video that I could post on YouTube, if that makes sense. In general, I like history and I want to learn about it, but sometimes I have to trick my brain into actually doing the thing I want it to. And honestly, like lastly, one of the main reasons I'm here is plain and simple, I just enjoy making videos. I had a really cool hobby in high school where I made anime music videos. I have a lot of fun putting together my set and being creative and writing scripts and tricking my brain into doing research. And I, as much as this recording was intimidating when I first started, I'm getting used to it and I've come to enjoy it. I think it's important that we talk about these sorts of things, and I also want to see other people do these sorts of channels. I think my ultimate goal is to see somebody, even if it's not me, in fact, I kind of prefer if it was someone else, to get big and bring these topics that I see everybody talking about in blog posts and Instagram and Twitter, and actually make these mainstream ideas that people are talking about. Because right now the only people that are talking about it are museum professionals, which is fine, but why not involve the public? But yeah, anyway, that's my... I don't really have a conclusion to this video, except for the fact that I'm having fun. I hope that my videos are mildly entertaining and very informative, like 60-40, 60% informative, 40% fun, 100% reason to remember the name. If you do know anybody else that is doing these sorts of videos, or if you're doing blog posts or something, throw your handle in the comments below and I'll check it out. Until next time though.